Nicholas Berggruen is one of the richest men in the world. Forbes estimates his net worth to be over $1.5 billion. He used to be known as the homeless billionaire, once living in luxury hotels with no permanent residence. But now he's settled down in Los Angeles and he's spending a big chunk of his fortune to create an institute there for great thinkers to consider the great issues of our time, such as the impact of technology on society. He's called the endeavor a secular monastery, and among its participants are former heads of state like Tony Blair, top academics like Joseph Stiglitz, and billionaire technologists like Elon Musk. I ought to tell you that I am on the Institute's advisory board. Listen in. Nicholas Berggruen, pleasure to have you on.
Thank you, Fareed.
Delighted.
About 10 years ago, you decided, at a point at which you'd made enormous amounts of money, that you wanted to educate yourself about ideas, about philosophy, and you hired professors from UCLA to tutor you. Why were you doing that?
It comes back to my teenage years. I was interested in politics and in philosophy because I really felt that ideas shaped who we are, and I still feel that way. So I went back to trying to learn what does the world of politics and the world of ideas look like, but not just Western, but also Eastern. And that's why I spent time with these professors from UCLA, and it reinforced my view that ideas make the world, and they make also politics. And by not only learning, but then by investing in the world of ideas, in the world of new ideas, I could not only learn something for me, but hopefully contribute.
So now you, like many billionaires, have pledged that you're going to give away most of your money. But what's unusual is that you are giving away the vast majority of it, and this is hundreds of millions of dollars, to fund ideas. There's no hospital wings with your names attached. You want to fund ideas. Why?
Because at the end of the day, they shape us more than anything else. Hospitals are very important. Luckily, lots of people are doing it. But we are still shaped today by Confucius, by Jesus Christ, by Karl Marx, for good or for bad. So the people who've really made a difference in terms of our cultures, in terms of who we are as humans, and our lives, our social and political lives, these people are thinkers. And today, I do actually think we need new thinking. I feel strongly that in this world where politics and conventional politics are being challenged, especially in the West, I don't think the answers are going to come just from political rethinking, but really from new concepts as to what it means to be a human and what it means to have an occupation in the future.
So explain, all this has come to fruition now with a center, a prize. Describe what you are doing.
We created an institute, the Berggruen Institute, 5 years ago. In addition to reward the importance of ideas, we're going to have a philosophy prize, similar to a Nobel Prize, but in this case for philosophy. So we'll have a yearly $1 million philosophy prize really underline how important ideas are and thinkers are.
And the center will have a $500 million endowment. This is above the Getty Center in Los Angeles, being designed by Herzog and Meron. So this is very large, very grand. And what do you hope will come out of it?
Well, I'm not sure it'll be grand itself, but the ambition is grand, for sure. And this is not a lonely project. It's a project that's being done with lots of people who are great thinkers and who have been great leaders. So it's really empowering more thinking and empowering these people to come together and to produce good work. So that's really the idea.
And do you now spend most of your time on this, on funding ideas, or are you still an active investor, hedge fund manager?
All my time is on this, on the institute, that, and the children.
That's your answer to
to Socrates' question of how to live a good life.
I'm lucky. It's a pretty good answer.
Nicholas, pleasure to have you on.
Thank you very much, Fareed.